Let us evaluate the integral 0 to pi x cos nx dx. In order to evaluate this integral, we'll be applying product rule that says integral of u into v dx equal to first function, that's your u, into integral of v dx minus integral of derivative of first function u dash into integral of v dx, but that has to be integrated once again. Here we take u equal to x and v equal to cos nx. Therefore, integral of x into cos nx dx equal to first function is x, integral of cos nx, integral of cos nx dx minus integral of derivative of x with respect to x is 1, and then integral of cos nx dx, but once again dx because you need to integrate it twice. Now if you integrate cos nx, then you will get sin nx by n. So here also, if you integrate cos nx, you will get sin nx by n. Now, this one we copy as it is, x into sin nx, sin nx by n minus, if you integrate sin nx, you'll get minus cos nx by n. So it is plus cos nx by n square. Of course, plus some constant of integration. So we have integral of x into cos nx dx equal to x into sin nx by n plus cos nx by n square. But the question is saying, compute the definite integral 0 to pi x cos nx dx. So we just need to put the upper limit and lower limit. We need not write the constant. X sin nx by n plus cos nx by n square. Sin n pi is simply 0. Cos n pi, let's write it as it is. Cos n pi. So we have computed the value of this function for x equal to pi. When you take x equal to 0, 0, 0 into sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1. We know that cos pi equal to minus 1, cos 2 pi equal to 1. So minus 1 whole thing is square. Cos 3 pi is, minus 1 to the power, yes. Cos 1 pi is minus 1, cos 2 pi is plus 1. So cos n pi is basically minus 1 whole thing to the power n. minus 1 by n square, we can write as it is. So this can be written as minus 1 to the power n minus 1 by n square. Observe that for even n, this integral is 0. Is this valid for n equal to 0? No. Let's compute even for n equal to 0. When n equal to 0, integral 0 to pi x cos nx equal to 0 to pi cos 0 is 1, so this is simply x. And that's equal to x squared by 2. And that's equal to pi squared by 2.